Everyone, this is Manuela again, and I just wanted to share what the Lord's put in my heart. I'm a little bit sick, so my voice is a little hoarse, but I was just praying and feeling grieved and heavy with everything that's going on in the earth, and the Lord just comforted me saying, do not worry about tomorrow. Each day has enough trouble of its own, and just knowing what we have to deal with today without worrying about, you know, Ebola and all the other calamities and all the little tricks of Satan, that in and of itself is enough. Yes, we need to be prepared, but we need to keep our eyes on Jesus, keeping him at the center front of our minds, because he shows us what to do step by step. And you know, I'm thankful that I'm awake and aware of, you know, the enemy's schemes, as far as, you know, aware of the reality of how he's moving. And but I want to be balanced about it and not get consumed by it or have to know every little detail if it doesn't serve a purpose other than getting scared, which can happen to any of us. So I am very thankful for the watchmen and their encouragement. And I just want to encourage us all to be led by the Holy Spirit, myself included. And to, I feel that we are called to in these last days, because the church, the mainstream church, is not connected. It's not a real unit. It's like a business. It's just people are, you know, spectators. And, you know, the church has failed in many ways to really represent Christ. That as believers, we need to come together as the real church in love. And, you know, not spread in a million directions, but maybe having, you know, somehow online we can, not online, but having connections just beyond just making videos, but have developing friendships with people. I know that the Lord works through relationships and friendships, and, you know, it's hard to get to know everybody that makes a video, of course. Although it's awesome to hear testimonies. I don't know, this is kind of rambling all over the place, but these are just the things that have been on my heart. That we really keep our eyes on Jesus and the prize, and not spread ourselves too thin, in that we can't be there for the people who need it well. You know, while we're trying to save the whole world or reach everybody, which we can't do. We can't reach every single person. The body needs to work together, edifying and building itself up in love. And people have different callings, of course, and some people are going to be more, you know, led to evangelize or preach the word. You know, and that's great. I just pray that everyone's gifts could be used in the right way and in the right context. And maybe the Lord will plant some more house churches, real house churches, in the coming persecution, which I believe there is a coming persecution in America. It's already started. I've been feeling it, gosh, in my spirit, rising up more and more. You know, all who suffer, I mean, all who live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. If you haven't already, then you may need to ask yourself if you're really walking with Jesus. We need to support each other in these struggles that we're having, through, you know, helping each other find each other to start local house churches. And I just pray for that real Christians would find each other, and that we wouldn't be alone in the world, that there would be connections locally as well. And then I do pray for that. So I just pray the Lord to continue to move And I thank him for the people he does bring into my life. And I pray that even locally where I live, and I pray that I could be faithful to share what he wants me to share, love and encouragement and the truths he reveals to me. I just pray for courage for all of us. So I'm sure there's more the Lord will show me some that I could say, but I want to keep this short because I need to be getting to bed. I'm going to ask for your prayers. I'm experiencing some difficulties at my job, just not being treated very well, and I don't know if I mentioned that, but if you could please pray for me and pray for my health. I have a lot on my plate, but the Lord keeps us going, and I thank Him for that. And I pray the Lord bless each and every one of you that know Jesus, and those who want to know Him. The Lord will reveal yourself Himself to you, and I just pray His blessing on all those who seek truth, righteousness, and love, the real love of Jesus Christ. God bless you.